trainer I've been hearing all about. Hey, nice to meet you. I'm Nia. I'm one of the battle trainers here in Faerum. There's lots to see around here. But don't worry, I'll make sure you know your way around. I battle alongside my trusty partner, Weavile. Have you ever seen a Pokemon this cute? Huh? He was just sleeping over there, but where did he go? I'll introduce you guys some other time. Right then, first things first. Welcome to the Faerum Battle. Working as one with your partner Pokemon and facing off in intense one-on-one battles is what makes Faerum Battles great. But first, you'll need this to get started as a battle trainer. Here's your battle AR. When you wear this, you'll be able to synergize with your Pokemon in battle. Your battle AR uses something called a Synergy Stone. There's actually a lot we don't know about them. But hey, we'll get into the details later. Make sure you take care of it. It's so exciting thinking about the brand new journey you're just starting out on. I'm definitely looking forward to seeing what sort of trainer you turn out to be. I'll give you whatever assistance I can, so just try to have some fun out there. Right then, let's get you registered. You'll be able to change your partner Pokemon later. For now, choose whichever one feels right for you.
All right, what's happening? Jay Shockblast here. We are trying this Pokin DX tournament. I still don't really... I still don't really know this controller. I got a pro controller, though. We're going with serious face. All right, my eyes, forest green. Yes. All right, so choose battle Pokemon. So we've got Darkrai, Plazekin, Pikachu, Lucario, Gardevoir, Pikachu Libre, Skeezer, Empoleon, Brixen, Machamp, Decidueye, Gengar, Skeptile, Mewtwo, Chandelure. I know who that is. Weevil. Ooh, Charizard. Ooh, Garchomp. I like him. Shadow Mewtwo. Alright, I think I might want to use this guy. Garchomp. He just looks the sickest. I don't know anything about the Pokemons, so... I mean, I'm really just kind of going blind here. You selected as my partner. Yes.
This is the Faerum region, where we are now. It's a huge island surrounded by nothing but the ocean itself. Faerum battles are super popular here, if you hadn't already guessed. The types of battles differ a bit from city to city, so I'll just give you the short and sweet version. To start off, right now, we're here in Old Faerum Town. It's also known as My Town, and here you can check your battle data and change your settings, stuff like that. Don't worry, whenever we head to a new area, I'll give you the rundown. I've got your back. Next up is right here, Faerum Stadium. This is where the Faerum League is held. This is a single-player mode where you battle your way to victory in the official league. Next up is Tellertown, I suppose. Here you can join in casual matches against CPU opponents. Did you hear? There have been some strange battles going on at the Haunted House recently. Do Do you think it's because of those rumors saying that you'll get something nice if you battle there?
Ooh.
Check it out if you're interested. When you want to battle against your friends, you should head over to Selen Island. There, you can battle using two controllers. If you want to battle with some nearby friends, you can also use local communication. Head to Thalia Beach if you want to give it a go. And then there's Mayo City, where you can battle against online players from around the globe. You can check out Battle Reef. In Techna City, you can learn all sorts of stuff about battles and practice a bit too. I'll give you a nice little walkthrough in the tutorial. Alrighty then, guess I went on a bit longer than planned. Feel free to start off wherever you want, but I think you might be best off heading to Techna City to play through the tutorial and learn the basics of Ferrum battles. Now then, where are we off to battle at next?
Alright, well, let's go to... Undertake challenges. I think it wants me to go to practice.
Here, you can learn about Ferrum battles and practice as much as you see fit. In the tutorial, I'll teach you all about battling from the basics. In free training, you can use a number of settings to practice however you see fit. If you have two controllers, you will also be able to control both characters in training. I'd recommend starting off with my tutorial. Oh, right. You can use the pause menu during battle to check your Pokemon's move list. It's pretty useful, so make...
Alright.
Choose your Pokemon. You all about the basics of the game. Now then, which? Alrighty, I guess we better start off. Go ahead and try. You can use the directional buttons to move around the field. You can also jump with the B button. If you press the same direction twice on the directional buttons, you can dash step forward and back or side to side. Okay, let's move on. Press this button to use long distance attacks. Long distance attacks are called ranged attacks. Try to land a few range. Phase you're in by checking here. Now then, how do you go about changing phases? Well, if you land a certain type of attack, you'll shift phase. Let's check out. hit your opponent with this attack. In group phase, you can dish out some serious damage. But here's where the real battle goes down. But you'll need to be careful. The way you move around differs a bit. Let's practice moving around in by pressing forward twice on the directional buttons. You can perform a forward dash step. By moving back twice on the directional buttons, you can perform a backward dash step. You can jump using the B button. In dual phase, the action is highly varied. You can also just land a bunch of hits. Send them flying back into field phase like this. Someone with wits like yours has probably already figured this out, but battles will involve shifting back and forth between field phase and... Plus, when you cause a phase shift, you'll get a nice little bonus. And by that, I mean you'll fill up your synergy gauge. We'll talk more about how to use the synergy gauge later on. By blocking, you can all but completely defend against your... Alright, let's just hold down the R button, and you'll be fine. Whenever you're in a pinch, just press the R...
It's the bumper, not the trigger.
Alright, keep an eye right here on the screen. Your synergy gauge. Your synergy gauge will fill up as you land or take hits. Once your synergy gauge is full, try pressing the L and R buttons. Your Pokemon used its synergy burst. Your Pokemon will be super powered while it's in synergy burst. Wreak havoc with synergy burst.
I guess we'll try Charizard.
In this course, I'll tell you all you need to know about battles and teach you some techniques. Press this to perform a long distance attack aimed forward. It's great because you can use these attacks to shift into dual phase, even from a distance. This is what you'll want to strive. Try to land a few forward.
Oh, I was pressing the wrong button.
Press the X button while jumping in field phase and land a hit and you'll cause a phase shift. You'll want to get the timing right just as you jump to dodge an oncoming attack. Try to land a jump attack. During dual phase, if you land a hit with the Y button, press the Y button rapidly. Land consecutive hits to get a combo. This is what we call a Poke combo. Land a Poke combo. While you're still getting the hang of battles, make sure to shoot for lots of Poke combos. A counterattack absorbs an incoming attack and quickly dishes out a counterblow. Time it just right, and you'll be able to strike back at your opponent. You can use counterattacks in both field phase and dual phase. Your opponent's attack. Super effective against counterattacks. That being said, they're not very effective against normal attacks. Use a grab attack on your opponent. Normal attacks. Grab attacks beat counter attacks. And normal attacks beat grab attacks. Basically, this attack triangle is like a fancy game of rock, paper, scissors. Trainers who master this attack triangle will take control of the battle. This thing over here is called the support gauge. Your support gauge will fill up as time passes. Once your support gauge is full, press the L button and it'll come in and use one of its Pokemon moves to help you out. During the planning time before each round, you can switch out the support Pokemon you want to use. You can choose which support Pokemon. You can select a support Pokemon that suit, or maybe even select a support Pokemon that'll help you particular opponent. Support Pokemon come in three different types: Attack, Disrupt, and Enhance. Attack type support Pokemon come in handy when you want to deal out damage and push your opponent back. Disrupt type support Pokemon typically swoop in to block your opponent's movement. Sometimes they can even counter your opponent's attack. Enhance type support Pokemon will power up your Pokemon or heal some of your HP, things like that. Pick a support Pokemon that suits your playstyle and be sure to use it. Sometimes, when you use support Pokemon, your battle Pokemon will receive a status. These statuses include positive statuses and negative statuses. First things first, positive statuses. While you're under the effect of a positive status, you'll get some sort of advantage. For instance, Eevee will give you a positive status that grants you a temporary increase to your attack. The effect depends on the support Pokemon, but things will be in your favor while you have a positive status. Next up, we have negative statuses. Get hit with a negative status, and you'll temporarily be at a disadvantage. Take Imolga, for example. He'll hit you with an attack that temporarily reduces your speed. Use these statuses to your advantage to get the lead in battle. Between rounds, I'll drop in to cheer you on. Depending on whether you win or lose a round, your support gauge or your synergy gauge may get a boost. There are several types of cheering. There are cheer skills that are in effect from the first round, as well as those with special effects. Be sure to test out any new cheer skills you get. Sometimes, during field phase, you'll find power scattered around. Synergy gauge. Power on the field will disappear if you don't pick it up after a certain amount of time. Go ahead and pick up the power that appears on the field.
I didn't realize they were all spawning.
The tide of the battle can really change depending on where the power appears on the field. Now, let me tell you a bit about each battle Pokemon's recommended actions. Why don't you try this out? Nicely done.
Tutorial finish.
All right, we got one more tutorial.
Which Pokemon are you battling with?
I guess we'll try somebody else new. Pikachu.
Pressing up on the directional buttons, your Pokemon will take a high stance. By pressing the Y button in a high stance, you can perform an intercepting attack on an airborne opponent. In a high stance, you can press the X button to use an attack that will parry low to the ground attacks. Try to use an attack from... to land a hit. By charging up your counterattack, you can increase the amount of time you can ward off your opponent's attacks. Try to charge up a counterattack. Buttons and R button to cancel and move into a dash. This is simply called a cancel. You can use counterattacks to deflect your opponent's attacks and then cancel. Try to cancel a counterattack. Piercing attacks are special moves that cannot be blocked by counterattacks. For example, counterattacks with a fully charged hold become piercing attacks. Your best bet with counterattacks is to take the initiative and get the first move in. In field phase, you can also hold the last hit of a homing attack to make it a piercing attack. Pokemon won't take any hits while knocked down, and it'll get back up on its own, too. But this will give your opponent the chance to move in for an attack, so you'll need to be careful. Depending on the attack, you may take some damage regardless of whether you had your block up or not. This is called block damage. But you'll never be KO'd by block damage. If you keep blocking against an attack, you'll notice that the block will start to turn red. If you don't release it, you'll eventually get hit with a guard break. When you're hit with a guard break, you'll be left momentarily defenseless. How many attacks you can endure before getting hit with a guard break depends on the poke. Blocking is important, there's no doubt about it. But try not to get hit with a guard break. While in Synergy Burst, you won't be stunned from taking a few small hits. So you can move in for the attack without worrying about your opponent's ranged attacks one. Try to hit an opponent using a ranged attack with a homing attack. When your opponent uses their Synergy Burst, you'll want to try to use the X button for strong attacks to stun them, or grab attack to try to stun them. You can link up one attack with the next. This is what we call a combo. Let's try to land a simple... First off, try out this combo. I'm sure you've already noticed that battle Pokemon all have different amounts of HP, right? On top of that, how quickly the synergy gauge fills up and how long a synergy burst lasts also differ from one Pokemon to the next. Crazy, right? There are all sorts of different battle stages, and the battle arenas themselves vary slightly in shape and size. Battle Pokemon all have their strengths and weaknesses, and you'll have to be ready to switch up your fighting style from time to time. As you battle, your Pokemon will increase its skill level. As you increase your skill level, you can apply those skill points to whichever skills you'd like. As your skills level up, you'll get all sorts of useful advantages. And remember, you can switch out your skill points from My Town whenever you want.
Tutorial finish.
All right. I am not going to do these two. These are just courses. This is a little look at Pokken Tournament DX, I believe, is what we're calling this. So.
Did you know you can get presents?
Interesting so far.
Check it out in the system menu.
But I'm going to be trying this game out, and we'll see how it does. Let me know what you guys think. And I'm just trying to get my Switch some good use. Hope you guys enjoyed this video. I know there's a lot of Pokemon fans out there, so let's see what happens. We'll see ya.